क्वेश्चन नंबर टू, द इजेक्टेड फोटो इलेक्ट्रॉन सो द फोटो इलेक्ट्रॉन विल बी इजेक्टेड सो दिस इजेक्टेड फोटो इलेक्ट्रॉन इफ इट डिस्कस ए पाथ लाइक दिस देन दिस कैन यू कॉल रेडियस आर इफ इट जस्ट अबाउट टू ग्रेस द upper surface, so then it's a magnetic field will be present. Let's see that how it will be. B bar, the velocity. I think it should be in this direction. No? B bar into the plane is given. I'll put it here. Why to confuse you? So this is the ammeter. So the photons are incident, the ejected electron, it will have velocity v like this. So b bar velocity force. So since this one, I think this correct, no? What earlier I did correct, it will be. So it's a negative charge. So it is going to trace like this. Now let this distance be r. The rough diagram I'm trying to put. This will be r, this distance will be, let it be r. So what is r is equal to? mv by qb. Okay, now how to get that v? K max is equal to hf, what all given? The work function is given 400 to nanometer. So hc by lambda, I'll take it. Minus work function. What should be the lambda I should take here? So as the lambda decreases, this K max will increase, no? And if you want to put radius R, momentum, you can write it as 2K max here by QB. Okay, now look at this. Now look at this condition, that one. So one which is having lower values of wavelength, for low, the K max will be more, no? And the K max increase R. What is the maximum permitted value of R? The distance between the plates. So this should be equal to D. Shall I write here? No. The maximum permitted distance. The distance between the plates is that can be the maximum possible value of R. So solve it. Substitute this one. Now you know HC. Lambda, what you should pick up? 400 nanometer. You should not pick up any other value. You can pick up any other value, but it's telling the minimum value of B. So why B will be minimum? I think you can check it from equation. R is fixed, no? So for maximum value of K max, so we'll get certain value of B. So minimum value of B is what? For lambda, it will come here. Okay, there's a plate. Photons are incident on it. Then the electrons are ejected. Number of photons that are incident, I think we know how to calculate number of photons incident. Ni should be equal to, is equal to intensity. Intensity into area will become power, or I'll write PS by energy of photon. What is the power? Intensity into area. Area of that SC is given. Energy of the photon will be HF. These are the number of photons incident. And it's telling efficiency is 1. Means like a 100% efficiency. How many photons are incident? Those many photoelectrons will be ejected. So shall we put here Ne? So here Ne is equal to Ni. Then. What is the photons are being absorbed, no? So what is the momentum due to the force due to incident photon? So what is the formula? or directly what happened, number of photons into change in momentum, no? So what all the force will be number of photons incident into change in momentum due to photon. Photons and electrons. So Ni we know, so directly write it ISHF. What is the change in momentum? Photons are being absorbed, lambda. What about the ejected electrons? They will have K max. What is K max equal to? HF minus phi. So what is the momentum of ejected photoelectrons? 2m. Why I should add? Because the photons are absorbed, no? They'll exert force towards left. And just showing it an angle, it is just assume that normal incidence. Listen. Negative charge will come. Now write the KVL equation. Potential of this is A, I'll write. This is B. VA minus V minus VB equal to 0. VA is what potential of this? KQ1 by R1. V minus potential of this is how much? Minus KQ2 by R2 equal to 0. The number of electrons emitted by the larger sphere. So what actually happens, the ejected electron, number of electrons emitted by the larger sphere, when E is the charge of electron, what actually happens here? See, you should try to understand. The radiation is incident. What happened to the incident radiation? It will come with photons. It will come with photon. So now is it all the ejected electrons will reach the other sphere? No, few will escape. And what will happen? Few what will happen? Will come and deposit on the smaller sphere. able to make it out? If all the ejected photoelectrons, if they come and deposit on this, then what will be the charge of both the spheres? Then Q1 will become equal to Q2. But it is not like that. So what is the basic idea of this problem? All the ejected photoelectrons will not be present on smaller sphere. On sphere B, I'll write it. Huh? I gave symbol also. I think this is very important. If all escape to infinity, then what happens? This charge Q1 will be shared by these two. But himself in the question is said, the charge on bigger sphere becomes Q1. I think just follow the question and the charge on this minus Q2. Only few electrons will reach the smaller, few electrons will reach B and few will escape to infinity. So because of that, it acquires that potential. Okay, fine. Number of electrons emitted. I think we can very much pick up this. I think this is okay, fine. So after this, the ejected is having a potential, no? So as the ejected electron is having K max here. So as it wants to escape to infinity, so the electrostatic field is set up. Now this electrostatic field, what it will do? So what will do? It will decrease the kinetic energy of this, and before reaching infinity, it will be pulled back. I think after this, the equation what we can write, K max is equal to HF minus phi. And what is K max should be equal to charge of electron into potential of sphere. Substitute that, you'll get it here. Number of electrons in larger sphere is independent of the potential of the battery. Not like that. cannot be like this. Okay, we'll move to the next. Okay, yeah, somebody asked 11th one. Huh? Even the metal surface is faintly illuminated means with a very less intensity, low intensity. Okay, fine. Is a faint fellow? Faint means weak person. Any other things? Okay, I think we'll come to the last bit of passages. I'm starting. So light is incident here. Then as the ejected electron will be ejected by this particular plate, negative plate is telling incident or negative plate. So as the electron ejected, so that this negative plate or plate B will acquire the charge on that will decrease because the electron will be ejected. So it's like a positive charge. So the net charge of plate B will decrease here. And these electrons will go and deposit on plate A. So the net charge of plate A will decrease here. So the charge on the plates will be decreasing. And look at the current constant. Current constant means here. So if you see that, so further what he is doing is going to connect an ammeter. Here a constant current flows here. And how much it is? 10 to power of minus 12 ampere. What do you mean the current constant? All the ejected. See, one K max is what? 1.5 electron volt. What about zero kinetic energy electron? A zero will be. And it's telling a constant current flows means what? The current flowing is a saturation. Don't say saturation. All the ejected. All the because of the electrostatic field present. So who will make it, who will accelerate this like a zero kinetic energy electron? So the electrostatic field will be in this direction. So even the zero kinetic energy electron also will experience a force. So it will accelerate. So therefore all the electrons will reach the plate A due to E bar. All the photoelectrons. Reach the plate A. I think that's a major concept. So straight away, so you can, what was the earlier charge? I think we can calculate the earlier charge. Earlier charge is equal to potential difference is how much V naught that was applied, 10 volt. So Q should be equal to C into V naught. So we got the charge. Then what is the current flowing? I equal 10 to the power of minus 10 ampere. So therefore this current should be equal to I is equal to Q by T. So now we know the current, we know the charge, substitute will get the T. This is initial charge, I'll put it, so that'll be easy for you. So this is that particular, what is the time? T1. So finally, what will happen? After that, what will happen? The charge, the current start decreasing. So what will happen is the charge will become zero finally. Here. This is what happens here. So on what basis you can say here? Say once, what will happen as the charge deposition on the plate A keeps on increases, electrons get deposited, the number of electrons on the plate A increases, then the potential difference here will decrease. And at one instant, what happened? The charge on the plate A will become zero, charge on plate B will also become zero. Then the fresh ejected electrons, so what they do? They will introduce a positive charge on this plate negative charge on this. Why do this happens? Because of incident photons. As due to photoelectric effect, the four electrons will be ejected. So this will acquire a positive charge. And how do it will set up field? Now it will set up a field like this. Is it all the electrons can now they reach? Earlier, this electrostatic field due to charge of capacitor was supporting for the all zero kinetic energy electron also to move from plate B to A. Now what will happen? Here, the ejected K max or pen S, it is having energy, it will try to move. What about the zero kinetic energy electron? In what direction will experience a force? Look at the electrostatic force, which I'm showing here now. The electrostatic force here acting will be towards right, so it will retard. So zero kinetic energy electron cannot reach here. So with the time, what will happen to amount of charge here? More number of electrons will be ejected, and K max electrons will go and deposit here. So charge on plate A will increase. Then the charge on plate A will, plate B also will increase. So electric field strength will increase. Then gradually, what will happen? Along with the zero kinetic energy, those with non-zero kinetic energy electrons also stop reaching the plate A, and finally it will become zero. That's what I mean to say here, according to the graph. Now, why the curve should be like this? Why not straight, sir? Why you are putting like that? Because these electrons practically. So what will happen to the continuously? What happen? K max. It's not that only initially K max kinetic energy electrons will be ejected here. And these electrons open when they come, there's some repulsive force between that also will occur. Due to that, the curve is not linear. Why do the curve is fluctuating here like this? Some sort of sign, because of the repulsive force between the electrons also. Those electrons which is about to reach here, other electron open which is moving may collide. So because of that, collision between electrons and also the repulsive force between them will make the current to fluctuate. This is what I think it's beyond our level to prove this particular graph. Just I'm giving explanation. So finally, what will happen? The ejected kinetic energy electron its energy will not be sufficient to reach particular thing. So can we calculate that? So what is that? K max should be equal to E into. So let me call this is V dash. So we know K max. We'll get that V dash here. So now what is the magnitude of potential difference between the plates at time T1 and at time T greater than T2? I think we can work out from this. Numerical value of T1 is this one initially. From here you have to bring it. Now what is the magnitude of at T1? What is the potential difference at T1? Potential difference PD across. Capacity is zero. Now V dash will be non-zero. Okay. Anything? I think one more left over. This is, I think, directly go for the saturation current depends on what efficiency. IH, the saturation current formula. Quantum efficiency. Intensity. Area IA lambda by SC. Is that okay? So this will be the saturation current formula. So how to calculate efficiency, and he has given that saturation current 4.8 milliampere. Very good problem again, this also he has given. Then power he has given. Then energy of the photon. So from power, what happened? This will become intensity. That one. So in terms of power, you can bring it. So this is about the saturation current. So from here is what we'll get eta. From eta, what happened? You can calculate the number of photo electrons that are ejected. This eta has to be calculated. How to calculate this? I think I'm confusing you. Let me put it this one. A number of photons incident. Power of source by energy of photon. Power of source given 1 milliwatt and 3000 angstroms. We'll get number of photons incident. Saturation current we know. From this, what happened? We'll come to know the number of photoelectrons. Getting this? So now you know number of incident photon, number of photoelectrons. Can we calculate efficiency? Clear? This is, so now this efficiency has to be used for the threshold wavelength for the cell. So you can work out all the things. Saturation current for second case, it should be Is dash should be equal to eta Ia lambda 2 by Sc. Or directly power of the source instead of all this. Number of photons incident in the second case, so we'll go like this here. Ni dash is equal to power of source Ps dash Ep dash. Then he's asking the saturation current. You know efficiency. From the efficiency, you know the efficiency will remain same, and you know Ni dash, so you'll get Ni dash. So Ni dash is equal to eta into Ni dash. And from Ni dash, you are going to calculate the saturation current. Okay, sir. Okay, all of you, bye. Okay, I'll stop the class. Thank you, all of you. And somebody asked any doubt.